Hey guys, hello, hello. We are excited to dive into this little mini training with you. Super excited.
I love it. This is one of my favorite platforms is Instagram. I love Instagram. I think it's so fun and it gives you this different level of connectivity to a lot of different people that you might follow or people that might follow you. It's just a new way to reach your audience. But for a lot of people, Instagram can feel really intimidating. I think for most of us, Facebook was our first like social media platform, so it's kind of like it's our comfort zone. Facebook feels comfy cozy. I love Facebook. I work on Facebook. So this feels like a really nice comfort ground. But then Instagram came out, and then it's like, oh, what's this? And how can I leverage Instagram? Do I want to use it just for personal? Do I want to leverage it for business? So getting clear on what are my intentions with Instagram and how to really maximize my time on there so it's a benefit for me and for my followers. So we want to share some of our tips, tricks, and hacks to really help you maximize that. And whatever your business goals may be, if it's just using Instagram to get a little bit more comfortable with kind of showing yourself online, or if it's to drive traffic to your business, I think it's just a great topic to discuss, especially in leadership. We want you guys to lead in all capacities. And if that means showing up on live video, something that might scare the poop out of you, that's important that you're showing up for your followers and you're setting an example for your teams. There's so many different ways that you can really be a leader, even just within social media, body positivity, spreading positivity. There's so many important messages that can be heard on social media. And when you can take the opportunity to step into your confidence and step into your leadership, you have this big, beautiful platform that you can leverage the heck out of. That's impressive, and that's something that we really want to support you guys
Amazing.
in.
So let's go ahead, since we're talking about Instagram. If anyone is watching the replay or watching live, drop your Instagram handle so that we can go and follow you. And if you're watching, go and follow one other person from the comments, just so we can spread that love and get more followers. Now, the thing is about followers, we get stuck on like this number. Oh, I got X number of likes, I've got X number of followers. Don't hang yourself up on that because there are a ton of micro influencers. And so it's not about nowadays having 10,000 followers because sometimes people with 10 or even 100,000 followers have less engagement. Some of these smaller accounts do. So the goal is engagement, quality over quantity. All right. So making sure that you're growing. We're growing too. We've got what, I think 2,500 followers in the year that we've been in business, which is fantastic. But if you've got 300 followers, that's okay too. You've got one follower. It just starts with one. You're influencing one person.
One person. Yes. That's the thing is you're not trying to influence and be like, oh my God, I'm gonna have so many people before I can make an impact. You think that you need 300 people or 3,000 people or 300,000 people that your message is better? You're serving one person. And that's a big thing is get clear on who you want to serve because we're not gonna serve everybody. We aren't gonna serve everybody, just as everybody doesn't serve us. You could hear our message and be like, oh my God, I totally resonate with this. And then Sally could say the exact same thing. You're like, not so into Sally, but I'm into them, right? So that's why, someone loves eating at Earl's versus someone loves eating at Cactus or someone loves eating at Boston Pizza. They are all restaurants that serve food. There are all influencers that could serve the same message. It's how you receive it. It's the same as how you give it. So it's not about the number of people that are following you that determines the impact that you can make on them. Because it just, if you get consumed in it being a numbers game and not about who's really following me, because that one person that listens to your message, that's the person that you're supposed to serve.
Totally. Love that. And I love that you started to get into the message because if you are trying to reach everybody, you're going to reach nobody. It's just going to be like, meh, it's too general for me, right? Whereas if you're specific, you're going to polarize your audience. That's a good thing. You want people to be like, ugh, and piss off so that you can be more authentic to who you are. And you want other people to be like, oh my God, she is my person. We're besties. I don't even know her, and yet we are the same person. Those are the kind of people that you want following so that when you post your weirdo posts that are authentic to you, that person watching is like, yes, oh my God, so good, right? So really get clear. This is the stuff that you want to be spending your time on. Yeah, we're going to go into hashtags for sure. So what we want you to do is really starting to identify what your niche is, what mm-hmm. it is that you are wanting to do, you know, what message, what people, thinking about the avatar that you're trying to connect with and building content around that. You know, mm-hmm. a lot of time you can have a random post, but for the most part, when someone visits your page, there should be a theme of what kind of message you're putting out there. Now, it doesn't have to be a perfect grid like we do pride ourselves on our cute little grid, but honestly, you do not need to have a grid either. You post whatever feels like the messages that your audience is looking for, that specific message, and you know, really create that connection with that specific audience, because that is how you will truly be able to form a movement of the same kind of tribe moving together and really getting a lot of engagement. And so, yeah, spend time staying consistent, you know, posting on there regularly. If you can't post daily, you know, at least post a couple, 3-4 times a week if you can. You can also get this app called Tailwind. We use that. Our assistant sets it up for us. And you can post 30 times a month to have it for the app for free. So that's once a day. That's what we do. You can pay for it and have it more if you want. Then you can schedule in your posts, so you don't actually have to have them, you know, in there every single day. And so staying consistent, having a consistent, clear message, you're really targeting that niche audience that you are looking for. That may take some time to kind of identify what it is that you're wanting. Like, are you wanting to talk about like fashion? Are you wanting to talk about, you know, women's rights? Are you wanting to talk about leadership? Are you wanting to talk about social media marketing? Like, find that niche and play with it. See what people react to. People really like when we have like infographics, when we have little things that is shareable content. People want that kind of information so that they can share it onto their stuff. See what your audience likes and keep creating more of that. Use them as a test.
Absolutely. And a big thing too, like, so I have my personal Instagram, which is like Allie McDonald. That's me, my own personal Instagram. On there, you'll find me fucking around with the dog, at the gym, eating snacks, having girls' night, watching TV. Like, it's just a day in the life of Allie. My feed is a day in the life. I'm on holidays, I'm traveling. Like, it's just kind of a narrative of me. And I love my Instagram, my personal Instagram, to be just like that. It's just me doing shit at home and hanging out in my life. And people like following that because they're like, oh, what's Allie up to today? Like, it's kind of like you get to like peek in, like you open the front door of someone's house. You're like, oh, what are you up to today? That's what my Instagram is like. You can guarantee if you go on my Instagram, you're going to see what the hell I've been up to today, because that's what I post about. I just post a myriad of things about my day, and that's what works for my personal. For Ambition Babes, our entire focus is built around leadership, empowering others. And if you look at our feed, all of our posts are going to be about leadership, how people are leveling up, how you move through growth, how do you move through problems? Do you have a money block? How can I work on my health and fitness? How can I lead in my family? Our biography, that little, thanks. I love Instagram. I think it's so fun. You have a little bio. So there's a little description. So when someone lands on your page, they can instantly read about you and go like, oh, empowering women to make an impact and believe in, oh, okay, like this is, you know, leadership. This is what these girls are about. Not like on my personal where I'm like, dog mom, adventure seeker, because it's not business. I'm not selling anything over there. I'm not doing anything over there other than just sharing my life because that's what I think is fun. But for our business page, for Ambition Babes, it's a completely different message because we have a completely different niche. That's my job. I'm going to show up in a different capacity over there and focus on the things that are within our four quadrants. What are we doing for business? What are we doing for mindset, relationships, and health? So we stay consistent in our message. If we're traveling, if we're together, we like to show our lives. If we do get an opportunity to be together in person, we like to share about me and Carly. So we're really consistent in that message. So if you're using Instagram to build a following around either your brand or your business, be consistent in that because people like to follow consistency. If it's like, I'm doing this and then this and then this and then this, it confuses your audience and your message is totally lost. People are going to be like, what? Do you sell Mary Kay or are you a dog mom? But then you're in Hawaii and then now you're at the gym and then now you're talking about the products and then now you're not, like, kind of like, what do you do? And you don't want your audience to feel confused. So you need to know what you're going to use your Instagram for. That's why I have a personal page, which can be my shlish of me. And then I have a business page, which gets to be focused around what our business actually is. So I think that's really important, is getting clear on what do you want to use Instagram for.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And for your posts, like on your feed, so the pictures that you post, that is kind of like your front facing stuff. So a lot of our stuff is quite curated. It's been edited. It's really nice work. We encourage people to share it. We even ask people like, hey, you know, we do call to actions on it. Like, you know, like this if you agree, or, you know, share this with someone, or share this on your stories if you can relate to this, or we ask them a question, like, what is it that you're struggling with right now? Because that engagement really is important. So on our front facing kind of feed, it's very professional and like, we really work on our message. In our stories, it's still circulating around our message, but it's less curated. It's just natural. We may come out of the gym looking super sweaty and, you know, maybe not so attractive, but it's who we are. And people like kind of seeing that behind the scenes. That's why I think a lot of people like to take a look in at, you know, what's Allie doing today? The stories, even though our professional business, you know, what did I post today? Oh, I posted like a thing of me making my smoothie because it's health related. And that's one of our quadrants. And then I spilt it. And then I like took a video of me slurping it up. Like it was just like a funny little joke because I'm, you know, I like to goof around. So does Allie. So it's still showing who we are. And you really want to show people who you are in your stories. And if you are your message, then it's not going to be some fake thing that you're putting on. It's not a show. It's just a part of you. You may not be showing everything about you for your business page, but you're still showing that authentic piece of you that relates to the message that you're trying to get across. So that's kind of like Instagram in a big kind of general nutshell and sort of what you can be working on in terms of, you know, growing a following and growing connection. And like we said, it starts with one and then it multiplies from there. And don't be so obsessed with the numbers or the likes or whatever. That's why Instagram actually even took off the likes option. You can't see now how many people are liking other people's posts. But you can turn on your, you can make your Instagram a business account, and then you can follow the analytics so you can start to see like what posts are working well. Oh, posts of me like a selfie, like anytime Allie and I have cute selfies together, they do way better than any of our professional pictures. People just love up close and personal of Allie and I, and we're like, can't you like the ones that we paid money for? So yeah, it's you really start to get an idea of what people like, or some people really like the quotes that we do or whatever. So definitely put it onto a business setting if that's your goal, if you're running it for some sort of business. Now, to get into some specifics around some of the nitty-gritties of like maybe some little tricks that you've never heard of before, our first piece of advice is get in there and play around. I'm sick and tired of people always being like, well, I don't know how to do a poll, or I don't know how to find this. And I'm like, have you even tried to go and look? Just go play around. Yeah. Have fun with it.
You're on your phone. Ooh, how do I do this? This is really hard mirror image. You swipe over and then you're into, I'm going to make a story. At the bottom, there's all these different things you can do. And then you could like make a story like, hey guys, I'm making a story on Instagram. So here it is.
Yeah.
And then I could swipe up and I can look at all these options I could use. I could tag my location. I could do Kelowna, BC. Then people, if anyone searches Kelowna, my story would come up in that. I can add graphics. I could mention someone. I could mention Ambition Babes. Then I'm tagging. Then like if it is a time, you could do, you know, polls, questions. So just swiping over to make a story and swiping up, there's so many options. And Instagram likes you to use these options. Like that.
Yeah, you absolutely get far more reach when you're using the tools that Instagram is using. So even getting comfortable with doing, you know, IGTV, you know, those kinds of things, doing Instagram lives, that is definitely going to increase your reach because Instagram is going to be like, oh yeah, okay, they're using all of the features. And same with, you know, the stickers and the tags and the mentions and all of those things. That's really great. If you're drinking out of, so I'm drinking out of a cup that says Shakeology. I don't actually drink Shakeology anymore. But if I was, like if I was a Beachbody coach still, I would tag Shakeology. I would tag Beachbody. I would maybe put a hashtag in like, you know, mom life or whatever, if I was, you know, driving my kids somewhere. And then you can also make it more visually appealing. If you shrink down the, like the video, you can shrink it a little bit just so it's not like right up in your face. And then you can put maybe some subtitles. You can use the text and you can say like some sort of caption that would basically get someone to turn the volume on, because a lot of people watch stories, believe it or not, with the volume off. Right. So if it's got a tag on it, or a caption that says, oh, my favorite recipe, someone would be like, oh, I want to know what they're talking about. They would turn it on and then they'd be able to hear the recipe, you know. Or you can also even like, you can type out what, if it's a simple little recipe, and then be like, screenshot this or hold down to read. If you've got, depending on what kind of content you're putting out, you want your audience to stay on your story longer. If you get them to say, like, maybe you've got an event or something coming up, you're selling something, you know, DM me to talk about this more, or vote in this chat. And like, you can say like, do you want more information? And you can put a little poll and they can type yes or no. And then you can go in and see everyone that typed yes. And you can DM them, right?
Yeah, there's ways of
interaction.
Yeah. All different ways that you can like start to actually interact with your audience. Like on my personal page the other day, I did a poll asking, like, I was going downstairs to clean my Airbnb suite. And I was like, do you guys want a tour? I'm like, I don't know. Would they want to come along for that? And I was like, and I made a poll, like, take me down there for the tour. And like, I'll pass. And like, everyone voted take me for the tour. So I'm like, well, then come on down to the suite, y'all. And I brought everybody in and gave a little tour. But I asked my audience first, or asking your audience any type of question, anything that elicits some sort of engagement from them, makes them feel like they're involved. But like Carly said, like, for the most part, if I'm on Instagram, I'm usually on quiet mode on my phone. So if I'm watching a story, I read. I will, and I'm a reader. Like, I'm always going to read. Even when someone's talking, I will choose to read first versus have to listen to them. Maybe I don't like the sound of their voice. It's like, here we are, come join us on Facebook. So at least if you can't listen, they still hear that same message. Like, oh, okay, the girls are on it on Facebook in their group. So it takes no time at all to just add in a little bit of text. You could do a hashtag just to beef up your stories, because it's such a personalized way to connect with people. Like, I personally spend more time on stories than I do on a feed.
Me too.
I'll maybe do this scroll twice, and then I'm like, done with that. And then I'm like, stories. I just find it more engaging, more real life, more applicable to what I want to learn about.
Yeah.
So just different things to consider. Again, how do you want to use Instagram? Does Instagram scare you? And ask yourself why.
Yeah.
Because if it scares you, if it feels like this really unknown place, it's because you're not clear on why you're on Instagram. And if you're not clear on what you're doing for your business or what you want for, you know, advertising or a platform, that's when you need to do that introspective work to go, what do I want to achieve? Why do Carly and I want Ambition Babes to have an Instagram? We want to be able to impact women, and we want to be able to reach a broader audience. So we need to be able to get our faces out there, because we want people to know, like, and trust us, so that when we have an event, they're like, I want to be there for those girls. That sounds so fun. I've been watching them for 8 months. Hell yes, I'm coming to Ignite 2020. Or when we do a course that we've been dripping content on them and we've been showing up 365 days a year, we don't just show up for a launch and be like, oh my God, everyone buy from us. And they're like, who the F are these girls? It's that they know and like and trust. It feels like you're with us in our living room, in our business, on our day-to-day activities. That's what forms connections and bonds. Think of the influencers that you follow. I'd actually love for you guys to share, like, who are some of your favorite people to follow? Like, I love, her name's Sarah Landry. Her hashtag is the Birds Papaya. Does anyone know of her? She's phenomenal. And she's all about body positivity. She's a mom, and she is like really breaking the norms around like what beauty looks like. And I love following her. We follow Jillian Harris, you know, what's going on with Leo and Annie. Like, I feel like I know Leo and Annie.
They're also great.
Like, you know, I love following Carly because she's just so funny. Like, you just think of the people that like who come up in your stories and you're like, I just love when they post. I love their stuff. What makes you love them? Mm-hmm. What makes them so appealing to you? Because that's what you want to convey back to your audience, is how can I appeal to my audience? How am I serving them? How am I showing up for them? Mm-hmm. Do I want to feel inspired today? Like, I love following Dave Hollis, Rachel Hollis's husband. His hangouts with his daughter Noah is so cute. And they have tea time, and I just love Noah. I'm like, oh my God, you're such a good dad. Like, I'm like, I wish you were my dad. Like, I wish you guys could adopt me. He just loves Rachel, and he's just always out running, and I'm becoming a runner, and I'm just so inspired by him. So it's like, who inspires me? And also, who doesn't serve you? Because Instagram can become a very toxic place for people where you feel trapped in comparisonitis. Their feed is better than my feed. They have more followers than me. That is such an unhealthy place to live in social media. And I actually am on my personal page. I'm on an unfollow spree, and it is great. I like have recently unfollowed like 94 people, and that number will continue to drop because if I'm on my feed and I see someone, I'm like, why am I following you? This is nothing. This isn't serving me. Unfollow. If I'm in stories and I'm like, oh, like the feeling after I watch someone's story is, ugh, unfollow. It's not serving you. And you want your social media to be a place of servitude, a place of gratitude, a place where you can feel uplifted. And those are the influencers and the people that you want to follow. And you get the ability to create that same message. We want to spread positivity. We want to spread inspiration, motivation. If it's that you're a beach body coach, like beach body coach it up. If you're a mom and you're like working for yourself, like own that message. But be clear in who you are and how you want to present your message, because authenticity will win every single day versus curated, perfect. Like nobody wants the perfect. That's why people like Carly and I's like fun selfies. They're like, oh, those girls, versus when we're modeling. And they're like, ah, whatever. We're like, what the hell? We were really good models. So people don't want this like fancy curated version. Like your Instagram doesn't need to be perfect. People don't want perfect. I don't want to follow perfect. It makes me feel shitty that I'm not perfect. And then everyone else is perfect. I'm like, fuck that. Like, I'm not following you. That's not the vibe I'm into. I want to follow people that make me feel good, that after I watch a little 15-second story, I'm like, ha, not, huh. And so you have to know how to preserve your own energy on social media so it feels like a place that you're uplifted versus drained. And just recognize the vibes that are coming through your social media, because it should be a place that's healthy for you and not somewhere where you feel like I'm not enough and there is no perfect Instagram. Like the algorithm and the hashtags and the this and the that. It's you. You're going to create your perfect Instagram. You're going to create what works for you. It's not about having 13 hashtags and then choosing the comments and adding this. It's like everyone gets so hung up on these minute details that, yes, they'll give you a bit, but it's you that's showing up consistently, building an audience and owning your niche. That's what's going to create your success, not you trying to master an Instagram algorithm and becoming a hashtag queen. That's just not what's going to build your brand. It's you, your authenticity and your consistency.
Totally. Now, I do know that people are going to want to know about hashtags, so we will cover them. But again, yeah, don't become obsessed with them. Like, do I use 30 or do I use 5? Honestly, people have had success with 30 and people have had success with 5. So what we do, we're just going to share what we do and what we've learned from other people is for hashtags, we personally, we make our post and then we make a comment with our hashtags. And there's usually anywhere from like 4 to 7 hashtags usually. And the thing about hashtags is, you want to, again, make it relatable to whatever your picture is, whatever you're talking about. So you wouldn't just want to put random hashtags in there that you know are popular and that you think you're going to get followers from. It has to, the bots will pick up on that and actually like ban you from Facebook shadow or Instagram shadow ban you. I heard that's what they're calling it. You also don't want to just use the same hashtags or like copy and paste them from a notes list. I was guilty of that in the beginning and I thought like, oh, well, these are all really good hashtags like boss babe and motivational, blah, blah, blah. And it was like, no, you're using the same ones. They can tell that. But another thing is you don't want to use really uber super popular hashtags. You want hashtags that have anywhere from 5,000 posts, because when you start to type in like hashtag blonde, it'll start to come up with blonde babe, blonde girl, blonde mom, blonde, whatever. It'll just start coming up with different, it'll give you suggestions. I love using that. I'll be like hashtag and I'll start to write something. And you want to find the ones that have anywhere from 5,000 posts to 500,000 posts. A lot of them have millions. Like when you go hashtag inspiration, it's probably 20 million. Don't use that one. It's too popular. You're going to get lost in that.
Yeah. Like if anyone ever, so then if I went on Instagram and I searched like hashtag inspiration, it's going to be like so many options that even if you hashtag your picture, you're up against a million other posts that also use that picture. So the likelihood that I'm going to somehow find your account through hashtag inspiration is highly unlikely. Yeah. It has to be something kind of specific. Like I'll want to search like manifestation in Kelowna. Like I want to know someone, like if I'm like, who does manifestation work in Kelowna? I'm going to look up like manifestation work in Kelowna, like as a hashtag and see who I can find. That's so specific, but that's specifically what I'm looking for. Or like I wanted to look for new hair extensions. I'm getting new extensions next week. You guys, this is not my real hair.
Nice.
I looked up The Extensionist and I wanted to know literally everything, like YYC Extensionist, The Extensionist, like people, hair tutorials, hair tutorial extensionist. That's so specific. But then I got to get to a page that was just around that. So know that when you are building out hashtags, if you can make it specific to you and your company, that post, that's going to draw in your niche audience instead of trying to serve everyone. Serve your audience and you can make your hashtags. Our hashtags are all a lot of, you know, based around leadership, because we want, if someone's looking for like, you know, women in leadership, boss babes doing leadership, leadership for entrepreneurs, like we want to be able to, you know, female leaders, like we want to find those people that are within that niche, mm-hmm. not just like boss babe, girl boss, girl crushing it. Like that's so broad and generic. Like, yeah, me and Carly are boss babes for sure. But what does that have to do with our brand? Nothing really in the realm of things. Like people might come across her page from that, but highly unlikely. So it's nice to tailor your hashtags a bit more to your niche and your brand specifically. So if someone searches that, then they're like, oh sweet, like who's this? I didn't even know, but I like searched your, like that's how I found like a lot of the people that I went to that I now follow is like from like a random hashtag search. I was like, oh, I like your stuff. But it'll get lost if you pick a hashtag that has like a million plus posts around it. It's too much.
Yeah, totally. Yeah. So 5,000 to 500,000 is a rough, you know, gauge of where you can be looking. Also something I like to do, a lot of the people that I follow that I look up to that are already in my niche, I go and see what they're hashtagging. What's a common one that they are looking at? So then I know that their audience, if I hashtag the same thing, they may see my post next to hers. Right? Oh, cool. They're very similar. That's awesome. You know? So in doing research, go look at the accounts that you like, that follow along with the message that you're promoting, the audience that you want, right? Start using some of their hashtags, get inspired from the different types of hashtags that they're using. Maybe hashtags you hadn't even thought of yet. It's like, oh my gosh, how smart is that? Again, you don't want to be too specific with hashtags, because if it's under 5,000, there's not enough to even, no one will search those. So you want to have at least 5,000 on the posts, right? But yeah, going to look at other accounts, that's another great way to gain followers, is to go to those accounts that have a similar audience and engage. If you could engage on other people's accounts every single day, even for 10 minutes, going in and commenting and maybe commenting a reply to someone's comment. You know, oh my gosh, you have two little boys. I do too. That's so awesome. Like hashtag mom boss, whatever. And just like fun little interactions with other people's accounts. First, the person is going to be super pumped that you're engaging on their stuff. Like they always love when you do those kinds of things. And then also the followers are going to love that you replied to them. And maybe they're going to go check you out. Also, anytime that you mention somebody, like we've watched or listened to podcasts before, and we'll mention, you know, Angie Lee or, you know, Chris Harder was one recently, and he shared our Instagram story on his Instagram story. We got a couple follows from that because we mentioned him, right? So if you can do those kinds of things, interacting with other people's accounts, tagging them, oh my gosh, saw this great post today that Kate did, love it, like, and tag her, you know, go check her out if you want more. She might then follow you. She might also share your stuff in other people. Like that's that give and take kind of relationship amongst followers, like, and accounts. If we can support one another, like, that's really what's going to get us all to rise, rather than being like, oh, I'm never going to tag them because I don't want them to buy their products. Like, I want them to only see me. It's like, no, like support one another. And yeah, like tag it up. And, you know, when it comes to hashtags, just really find stuff that resonates with you, that has the right amount of people, and don't take it too seriously. Like, people get so caught up, like, I don't even know what a hashtag is. Neither do most people on the internet, but just have fun with it. Play around, see if you look at your analytics, you know, if you've got a business account, you can go in and see how many people saw your post because of your hashtags. If you have, if that number keeps rising on your post, you can tell, wow, my hashtags seem to be working. If it's not doing anything, clearly your hashtags are in the wrong kind of niche, or you're not doing them right, right? Play around, test, and see what people like.
Yeah, I love that you said that, Carly. I think engagement and interaction is so key with your audience. Two things to mention here is, if someone DMs you, DM them back. Your DMs are a beautiful place to connect, and treat your audience as though they're your best friends. So if someone sends you a DM, write them back. You can voice memo on Instagram. You can have a nice conversation. Like, we always do welcome messages to people. If someone new follows us, we send them a welcome message like, hey, thanks for the follow. Love connecting to new boss babes, like, et cetera. This is our Facebook group for our leadership page if you want to come join us there. Like, we'd love to be able to at least send them a message just to welcome them to our page. Then they might respond like, awesome, thanks so much. Like, then we're responding back like, yeah, you that girl. Like, how'd you hear about us? Like, this is so awesome. And we've been able to connect with some really amazing people just from our DMs. The same with commenting. If we make a post and someone comments like, great pick, girls, like it, reply, oh, thanks, babe, so much. Like, woo, have a great day. Like, you know what I mean? Like, don't ever leave your followers in the dust where they're like, man, like, I comment or message her and never hear back. Like, just like, then they feel like this robotic, untouchable person, and people don't want to follow people that don't engage back with them. So not only engage on other accounts, it just shows that you're a real person, that you're liking accounts, that you're commenting on their pictures, that you're sending love to them. You're going to get 10 times love back to you when you put out and serve versus just want to take, take, take. Like, I want all the followers and I want all the people. You really have to give that energy back out there. So engage, like, show up. And you have to treat Instagram, again, if you're just using it for personal, then maybe I just won't make a story for the week because I'm just not in the mood. Me, Allie. In Ambition Babes, oh, we're going to make a story. We're going to make something in the day. If it's Carly posting, if it's me posting, if we're sharing a meme that we really loved that we thought was powerful, because that's our business. That's a completely different part of myself. It's the same as on my Facebook. I show up differently for my Facebook business page than I do on my Facebook personal page. So know, how am I using Instagram? And then show up consistently and authentically, and then engage in your DMs, in your comments, and then with your followers and on other pages that you feel inspired by, show up for them and they're going to show up for you. Yeah. It doesn't have to be, again, like this big, complicated bubble. It's a social community. That's what Instagram is. It's a social platform. It's intended for sharing and growing and inspiring and motivating. And again, unfollow the people who don't fill your cup and bring it. When you close that door, it opens three more for you to fill your cup with new people that are going to inspire you and be like, man, I'm so glad I'm not seeing Carly's story anymore and all I see is Allie's. Like, that really is what works better for me. So you just have to know how to preserve your energy and respect your space, so then you get to show up in your highest capacity and not make it this complicated thing. But again, it's just having content sometimes can be really scary for people too. What do I post? I don't know what I want to share. That's, again, getting really clear on your message. If you know what you want to share about, like, we want to share about us and our business, being entrepreneurs, diving into leadership, the facets of our business, our four quadrants of greatness, so we can build content around that. And then in and amongst that, we always do like a meme post, like a quote or something powerful, like a really strong message. People love sharing that. Like, I don't know about you, but on everyone's stories, for the most part, every single day, I'll see like a graphic of like some sort of a sentence or powerful, like, oof, it's like, let go of people whose energy doesn't serve you. And people will just repost and share. That's a huge thing. And then I'll, like, I just started following a new account from one girl that shared a post. I was like, ooh, that was really powerful. I clicked it and it goes see posts. So it takes you to that person's account. And then I started going through their page. I was like, ooh, I love all these posts. And now I started following them. That's how easy it is when you can just share and repost, but you have to have that content that people then want to share and repost on their pages. So again, just getting clear on your messaging.
Yes, love that. So before we wrap up, a couple more things. This triggered me when you were saying responding to people. When you're responding to people, one thing that we learned also is that you want to have more than like say 3 or 4 words. You don't want to just put an emoji like, oh yeah, thanks, and then like a little peace sign or like a heart or something. You will actually get more engagement because Instagram will see that you're not just like, you know, just scrolling through and just giving an emoji or something, that you do want to interact with your people. So make sure that you give a thoughtful response, maybe even engage, ask them a question so then they respond back and then you could respond again. It's like you created, you know, 4 messages that started from 1. So that's another good tip. And also when you post, don't post at a random time and then leave it. Like post and be ready to respond to people as they come through, because that will boost your algorithm. There's so much to learn about algorithms, but honestly, it changes all the time. But if you can at least just stay consistent and post when, you know, your audience is most active and then be available to somewhat interact, it will help it for sure. And then one other thing is, yeah, just like in your stories, making sure that you're showing a lot of your face. People like your face. And it's been proven that, you know, if you're taking a video, people want to see you as opposed to the camera flipped around and you're just videotaping, you know, what's in front. You want to have diversity, maybe a picture, maybe some video, then maybe some how-to stuff, whatever it is, interactive stuff. But at the end of the day, people love to see camera to face video.
The old money maker.
Yeah. And no matter what you look like, because it doesn't matter. You don't have to be some supermodel or anything. On days that I look the funniest, I'm like, well, people are probably going to click on this because I'm having some funny looking hair today or something, you know?
I have not washed my hair in days, you guys. Days. And I work out every day and I just, you know, blow dry out the sweat and put in another layer of dry shampoo and call it a day, because it's like, who has the time to style? I don't. So this is what you get. If I had to show up perfect every day, I would be exhausted and never show up at all. So you just have to show up as you are, and people like that.
Totally. Amazing. Okay, guys. Well, I hope that was helpful. This is definitely just scratching the surface when it comes to Instagram. If you see people's stuff that you like, look at their posts and just study them. Oh, what kind of filter did they use there? What kind of stickers did they use there? Oh, that's so neat. Like some people get so fancy with their stories. You can actually get templates for your stories. You can go all out. YouTube it, guys. If you're wanting to get that fancy, there is training out there for you to do that. This is just for the beginners to get started and just to know that it's not that scary and you're making an influence already. And if you want to get super fancy and do some super cool stories, then just go and look around, play with your account. You know, there's so many fun things that you can do. And yeah, just don't overthink it.
Love it.
Okay, guys, well, have a great afternoon, and we'll see you on the next one.
Amazing. Bye, guys.
Bye.